I'm hoping that they didn't shart too many times. A couple weeks ago, I took my ex-boyfriend's jacket and sewed it into a pair of corduroy pants in what I believe to be largely my most successful sewing project to date.
Boop.
And I want to replicate that success, but in reverse. So I want to take a couple pair of pants and try to turn it into a denim puffer jacket inspired by this Alexander Wang winter collection piece.
Boop.
These are not my ex-boyfriend's pants. I don't know whose pants these were. I bought them at the thrift store. But if they belonged to you, call me up and we could make these an ex-boyfriend's pants, if you know what I mean. And I don't know if this is gonna work at all. But I'm thinking I can stuff it with the material from some old pillows that I happen to have on hand. I have one that has like polyester fill and one that has like feather fill that was like given to me by my brother because he didn't want it. And judging by the pictures, I zoomed in, y'all. It looks like they sewed the jacket together, they did all of the construction, and then they bleached it all at once. We're gonna sew it together and hope I don't ruin it in a big bathtub full of bleach. That means the first thing that I want to do is cut a few little sample pieces and test bleach them and make sure that these two jeans are actually going to bleach and turn out the same color. So while we were waiting for the denim to bleach, I did go ahead and cut some pattern pieces out of the fleece lining fabric that I had purchased. These pattern pieces are ones that I just made myself from a jacket that I like the fit of, so I wanted to cut them out of the lining pieces first to kind of test how they fit.
Whoa, girl.
The rest of it is pretty cool. It's really warm. Like, I am sweating, girl.
Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. Ay.
They did not bleach the same at all. Kind of just gonna go with it and lean into the fact that they are two different shades of denim. And I did that thing that you do when you're like really procrastinating where you like make a to-do list or like a planner of what you're gonna do. And I made like a big, I made like a huge. We need to do some deconstruction first, which is the first item on my to-do list that I planned, which just involves like salvaging a little bit of extra denim because the panels that I have planned really take up like all of the, they take up like all of the fabric, so. Okay, so while I was seam working, I came up against an obstacle, which is that underneath the pockets is like raw denim, like raw unprocessed denim that's like a different color and different texture. So I went out and bought another pair of jeans. So we're at three pairs of jeans now. So we're ready to like cut. We're ready to cut. We're ready to do like the and cut. Do I look like I'm joining a motorcycle gang? Okay, I finished cutting out the project panels and I just pinned them together to give it a try on before we get to sewing. I'm happy with the fit, but okay, so here's what we're working with. That took me, like so many hours to figure out, but we've moved some panels around. These seams line up better now. Two pant leg cuffs sewn together. All I had left for fabric. I didn't have any fabric left. Right now it's just held together with pins. But the next thing I want to do is actually sew like these panels together and the back panels together, and then we can get to actually like the lining and everything. Okay. A moment of silence for our fallen fabric scraps. And if you wanted to save yourself a whole bunch of trouble, just go to Joanne's Fabric and buy a roll of denim, and you can skip right up until this point of the video. This was a lot of work to get here, but it was worth it. If you guys recall, like a million years ago, we cut these panel pieces out of some fleece material that I purchased to line the denim. So I went ahead and made sure that my pieces actually lined up with the fabric, you know, the fleece fabric. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go along the seams that we've created And in the case of the front piece, I'm gonna add a seam as well. And these are gonna be like the pockets where we'll actually put the stuffing in to puff the jacket up. And I was very careful to make sure that the seams that I was creating, or like the pockets or the puff sections, were perfectly aligned to each other, like across the zipper in the front, and also along the side seams to the back, so that when we sew everything together, it's not gonna be like, it'll be like nice. So now there's actually stitches going along the lining piece, creating pockets into which you can put like your stuffing, your puffering. Where I had long sections of denim that like were just, you know, straight pieces of denim, I just top stitched it to the lining. So these are my sleeve panels. They're shockingly wide. I didn't realize how big sleeves are, but they're huge. So get a large pair of jeans for this. Because they're so wide, I ended up cutting them from like the inner part of the leg, which is why it has a seam running down the middle, which I thought would be like a cute detail, and it saves me time. So these ones are just gonna get stitched to their matching lining piece. And if you look at the model on the website, you'll notice that the jacket that I'm referencing, it has smaller sections on the sleeves than on the body pieces. The sleeves are divided into like 5 or 6. Okay, also sidebar, there's like a big dried blood stain on this table that's for sure new, and I like don't know where it came from. It feels as though we've been on such a long journey, and I'm finally awakening to this glorious day. They're all well-used pillows that have nice yellow stains on them. Oh, there it goes. It's filled with like this stuff, you know, Santa's beard kind of situation. I think mostly I'm gonna use that because it seems easy to work with. I'm just so excited, you guys. We're cutting this open. We're ripping it open. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh no. You guys, I've always wanted to do something. Oh my God. Oh my good God. What have I done? Oh no. No. All right, I'd like to offer some pretty strong recommendations to never do that ever. That was a great way to waste like 2.5 hours of cleaning. And with that, I've decided to only go with the polyester. Literally, like, there are still feathers, like, in the air, falling. I keep coughing because I've inhaled feather dust. So this part's just gonna be, you know, pretty straightforward. I'm just taking fistfuls of this fill and shoving it into all of those pockets that we've made. And I don't wanna go too crazy with this. The part of the thing that's gonna happen is the more I stuff it, the more it's gonna bulge out and it's gonna eat fabric. It's gonna make every bulge is gonna make the length shorter. This is one kind of roughly done. You can see how much of a difference that makes compared to, quite different, right? Like, it actually looks like a puffer jacket now, I think. So that's pretty cool. And I'm realizing that you actually need a lot less material than I thought, because like, it very quickly gets to be like immobilizingly tight. This is so funny. Hey, I went with like way less puffing than I anticipated. I wanted it to be quite dramatic, but ultimately this is closer to the original. The original is not super puffy. And I'm ready to assemble. Everything's good. We have to figure out the collar, but I'm gonna do that after things are together. I do want pockets, and look, I know the original has welt pockets, and I don't know how to do those. I don't really think that welt pockets are possible with this design of stuffing. So we're doing little side seam pockets. So I cut out some pocket shapes from the fleece lining, and I added a little strip of denim to it, which is gonna help conceal gonna help conceal the pocket when it's sewn in. You sew one side of the pocket onto the back panel and one side of the pocket onto the front panel at the side seams. And I'm gonna sew bright blue denim to bright blue denim, so right sides together. After we assemble the garments, then we'll sew the pocket together and close the pocket shape. It's like starting to make sense for the first time, this whole project, and I'm kind of dying. Pretty good. It looks pretty darn good right now. This collar, I just did a couple of pinnings. I want to make it really puffy and dramatic because I think that's going to make this jacket actually look modern and less like a Western grandmother jacket. Like a Western grandmother, lasso, there's a new sheriff in town, throwing beer at each other in the saloons. So that's what we're going to work on now. Something that I've been thinking about a lot is the fact that this collar is going to be up in and around my face, and that I harvested the fabric from jeans that was worn on someone else's fiery booty. So I'm hoping that they didn't shart too many times. I really wanted it to look like quite the like pillow, like a little neck pillow. I'm on an airplane. You know, they didn't have airplanes back in the day. I think that's what makes this feel more modern. Okay, so for the collar, instead of being lined with fleece, it's lined with denim. And I'm gonna insert a triangle of extra denim. And that is gonna kind of like balloon the outer piece out and give it like this pillow shape where I can actually fill it with more stuffing without it getting super tight and snug on the neck. We are going to pin these together and sew it along. This is gonna be what will be the top of the collar. And it looks kind of weird when you hold it straight, it looks like there's too much fabric. But when you wrap it around your neck, and then we are actually going to finally work on pinning this and sewing this and the zipper to the jacket. Because in the original design, the zipper goes all the way up the collar, and I want to emulate that. The way that the zipper and the collar and the jacket play together is very confusing, like the order of operations for how to do it. And I ended up writing up a little one-page document for myself to follow. Of like, sew this, attach this, sew that, press. You know what? It's been a long journey and we are absolutely finishing this today. And I found a bunch of little scraps to make these long strips. These pieces are gonna be facing along the inside like so. Then I also sewed a long tube of fabric and flipped it inside out so that I have the storm flap and I just like a tapered end. That's the little piece that comes up over the collar so that you don't have a zipper rubbing up against your chin. Then I also have a nice long zipper and get this bad boy done. Come on, let's go. I'm so excited to be here. So I'm gonna take the zipper, I'm gonna place it right side down, meaning like the actual zipper pull is gonna be down against the jacket. The zipper goes down, and then on top of that zipper that's faced down, I'm going to add a piece of facing that runs from where the collar starts down to the bottom, and then we'll sew all the way along the zipper using a zipper foot attachment, which is like a narrower thing so it's easier to get close to the zipper. This storm flap chin guard thing also gets sewn under the zipper at the top as well. So I'm also going to kind of open up that seam on the collar where the lining of the collar and the facing of the collar is, so that the storm flap can, the chin guard slash storm flap can go up through the collar seam and then down on the inside of the jacket in one straight line from there. So lots of moving parts on this jacket. I sewed a zipper, bitch! Wow, I sewed a zipper! The stitching, I have to tell you, is awful! It's so bad. Sewed a zipper. Zipper, baby. Oh, baby. This video is like a million years long. Am I ever gonna edit it? I don't know. Will you guys ever see any of this? I don't know. Update, I think I overfilled the neck. Look at it! What's that? I wanted to give you guys a little bit of an update because we're nearing the end and I did do some stuff off camera because I wanted to. And one of those things is I put an elastic into the cuff of one of the sleeves. Basically what I did was take an elastic that comfortably fits around my wrist. I went kind of loose and stuffed it inside. Great. Another thing that I've been working on that I went halfway and then stopped was putting bias tape over the inner seam. So you can see the left side here is the side that I've already done. It's messy, but it hides all of these like raw denim seams and like loose threads and stuff and protects it. I just cut these long strips of fleece and like wrapped it. No, you just shove it through there. You just go. And for the bottom, I decided to do something very similar to the cuffs where I'm just going to attach an elastic to each part in the front, flip up the seam and hand stitch to like hide the elastic inside. Yeah, lots of hand sewing. So we're going to do that hopefully in the next like hour before I go to the gym, although that is an ambitious goal. And then we'll be all done. Wow. What a journey we've taken together, you guys. You guys, we're all done. This is the final jacket. I have decided not to bleach it. You can't tell me that I didn't plan on bleaching this jacket. I did. I purchased the bleach. I purchased a vessel in which to bleach the jacket. I even did research on industrial bleaching and the chemicals used to neutralize the chlorine ions. Anyway, we're not gonna bleach it. I think that I actually really like the uniqueness of this jacket. I thought the bright blue denim would be kind of ugly, but it turned out pretty good. Here is how the jacket turned out, the final reveal shots, the narcissistic modeling, all of it. These used to be pairs of jeans from, you know, hanging in a thrift store, and now it's this jacket hanging off of my body, which is really cool. Anyway, I'll see you next time, I guess.